हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम विद अ न्यू क्लास ऑन कैट्स रैट्स एंड बग्स इन बोर्नियो। एंड स्टूडेंट, इन आवर लास्ट फ्यू क्लासेस ऑन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव सक्सेसफुली कंप्लीटेड द स्टोरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एज वेल एज द इम्पॉर्टेंट टेक्सचुअल क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। एंड टुडे स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर प्रोसीडिंग विद द टेक्सचुअल ग्रामर। एंड the grammar that have been included here is articles. And students, as before this chapter itself, we have made few detailed discussions on articles. So I hope that you have got some idea at least about articles. And today we are going to make again a discussion on this topic, as it is given here, so we have to make it. And if you have any doubt in the regarding classes, it's you can now clarify all this. Now let me first start with it. So first of all, the definition of article is that it is a word that is used to modify a noun, which is basically a person, place, object or idea. Means we have to put articles before the nouns of a sentence. Now we have two types of articles. One is definite article and the another one is indefinite article. So the definite article is the and the indefinite articles are a and an. Now we will make a discussion on the uses of indefinite article, that is a. So students, first of all, the first use is that we use a before common nouns which are singular in number and begin with a consonant sound. Say for example, a boy, a toy, a pen, etc. So students, it means that if the noun starts with a consonant sound, consonant letter, and it also in singular number, then you have to put a before it. Then number two, we put a before the nouns which starts with u but sounds as u. Say for example, a utensil, a university, etc. So students, if the first letter of a word is u, which is a vowel, but since it is pronounced as u but not as a like umbrella, so we have to put a even if it is a vowel. Next, we put a before the nouns which starts with the letter o but sounds as wa. Say for example, a 1 rupee note, a 1-eyed monster, etc. So students, generally the word starts with o. Say for example, orange, the first letter is pronounced as o, but here if the word starts with O and it is pronounced as wa, which is exceptional, so we have to put A before this noun even though it is it falls in the category of vowel. So students, I hope you have understood the use of A, and it means that A is also used before nouns that begin with a vowel but has a consonant sound. Now let me proceed with the use of N. Number one, we put N before the singular common nouns which start with vowel sounds. Say for example, an eagle, an egg, etc. In student, the first and foremost general use of N is we have to put N before the words that start with a vowel letter as well as singular in number. Then number two, we use N before the words which start with H but sounds like O. Say for example, an honest man. So student, we know that H is a consonant sound and is pronounced as H, like here. But if the first letter, that is H, is silent in the word, say for example, here it is honest. Here the first letter H is not pronounced as it is silent and it is pronounced as O, which is a vowel sound. That's why we have to put N before it even though it starts with a vowel sound. So students, N is also used before the nouns that begin with a consonant but have a vowel sound. So I hope that you have well understood the uses of A and N. Then let me proceed with the uses of the. Here number one uses the is used for whenever we refer to a particular thing or person. So for example, give me the pen lying on the table. Means in if you are referred to a general noun, then it is okay. We can put A or N according to the vowel or consonant sound. But if we are indicating a particular noun, then it will be the use of the here. Then number two, N is used when we refer to a particular person or thing for the first time, but the is used when we speak of that person or thing afterwards. Say for example, a man came to our house yesterday. The man wanted to talk to father. So students, whenever you will talk about a person, thing or animal for the first time, you will refer to A or N. But afterwards, if you make some more discussion about that, so then you have to put the before them. Then number three is the is used before seas, oceans, rivers, mountain ranges, etc. For example, the Narmada, the Himalaya, the Pacific Ocean, etc. The number four, when there is only one noun of the kind being referred to, say for example, the earth, the sun, etc. The number five, with proper nouns like the names of holy books, famous buildings, monuments, newspapers, trains, ships, etc. For example, the Holy Quran, the Ashram Tribune, the Rajdhani, etc. The number six, with superlative degrees. For example, the most intelligent, the tallest, etc. So we have three degrees, students: positive, comparative, and superlative. And superlative is the third degree. If the third degree persist in a sentence, that before it we have to put the number seven, to show the position of the noun. Say for example, the first, the second, etc. So student, I hope that you have well understood the articles, because before it also we have a detailed discussion on all of this, and after reading it again and again we have got the basic distinction between definite and indefinite. It is that the is the definite article because it is referred to a specific or particular thing, but on the other hand, the indefinite articles, it doesn't refer to any particular, means it refers to only general things. That's why the basic difference between indefinite and definite articles is that definite refers to a definite noun, whereas indefinite refers to no definite nouns but only a general noun. So students, I hope that if you have well understood this articles today, and today we are not proceeding further anymore. And here is a home assignment for today's class, and in tomorrow's class we will discuss something new. As for now, thank you so much.